So what is this fan up here? This is my childhood fan. I've had this as long as I've had these awards here. I've had this fan. Okay, this is bought from a store. It's not the one I built. This, as you can tell from the flickering, we have a light over here. This is just the light in my room. This is a 32-inch fan from Flexolite. Flexolite, you spell, if you want to go to your website, go to flex-a-lite.com. This is the 32-inch fan you can get from their heavy-duty division of fan blades. So, what we have here are 30 sets of each containing 8 AA rechargeable batteries. Okay, so we have 30 times 8 AA rechargeable batteries. That's 240 rechargeable batteries. So you would think this runs a long time, but how much current does it use? As you can see in this meter, it's drawing from 0.00 to 0.1 amps. Now, most of the time, it only shows up to 0.09. Sometimes it goes up to 0.1. But because most of the time it goes to 0.09, we could say the average goes from 0 to 0.09 or 0.045 amps. Okay? Now, we measure the voltage later, and we can take the apparent power of the system. We take the simple product of the voltage and the current of this system to measure what is drawn from the batteries. Last time I checked, it's 265 volts. But in the meantime, we'll compare the output of this ceiling fan with this Newman motor with its attached fan blade. Now, we're gonna do several steps here. We're gonna measure this at arm's length, elbow length, and hand length, okay? You heard that? So here's, if you listen to this sound, the wind, and I'll shut up. So what you just heard is the sound coming from the fan, this old childhood fan I've had, according to my elbow length, my shoulder length, and my hand length. Okay? Now we'll do the same thing for this fan. Okay, now, as you can see, you can judge for yourself which sound is louder, okay? So, between this fan and this fan, I would say this fan is putting out more power than this fan over here. This childhood fan is putting less power out than this Newman motor. So, this is a 36-inch fan at the highest setting. Just to prove the point, I'm going to put this camera right next to the handle like this. Now, I'm going to pull it down one time. Now I'm down one speed. Okay? Now I'm going to go down another speed. Okay? Didn't speed up. A third time. Now it should be off. It's completely off now. Now it's just spinning. Okay, obviously, hit this one more time, it goes on again, and speeds up. That's how this fan works. This is the highest setting. It's a 3-speed fan. I can just hit it 3 more times, then another time. It's a
three-speed fan, plus off. This is my Newman fan motor. It's not that sophisticated. It doesn't have that kind of switch. But, again, at arm's length, it provides more wind. Now, granted, it has more space on the back, but this area here is constricted. The space between this fan blade and this coil and the others is reduced compared to the space between this fan blade and the ceiling. Now, given all those things, now this meter had just turned off. We need to refresh it. We can measure what kind of current it has. Now, again, from 0.09 to 0.01, 0.01 again, 0.0 to 0.08, whatever. Still, you can tell that the average is half of 0.09. That's an estimate. It's not exact, but it's a good guess based on what this meter shows. And if it has a systematic error that pertains to this meter, you could go and look at the previous videos and compare the current draw of those videos. Okay, first of all, and the other videos that I have the fan running, I have the same meter, so you could compare the currents. So in that way, you could compare the past performance of this device relative to what it is now. Now, I have four coils. This is a relatively new setting. This is my second video about this. I'm about my third video of this 32-inch fan blade, if not the fourth. Something like that. Alright? But now, the thing about the setup is now I can show you the actual commutator. Now, I'll have to put this sideways, unfortunately, but to give you an idea, this is the commutator I have. I've been changing it every now and then. I've been reluctant to show all the details because I have had it improved it. As you can see, in this commutator, I have had a wire wrapped around a twist tie, like so, which strikes the copper pipe, so this acts like a broken segment commutator. I have all these wires connected in series, like that. Alright, this wire over here connects to the end of that battery pack, and the beginning of this coil is over here. Now, if I want to adjust the timing, for example, let's say I don't like the noise, then what I do as you can see, it's a mechanical commutator, it's not perfect. Compare it to this fan. Again. And this fan. Alright. Now that I adjusted the commutator, what am I drawing? From 0.01 to 0.07 to 0.00. Obviously, I've reduced the current draw. Now, did it show just 0.08 amps just for a short time? Yes. But still, the current dropped. Now, I only have a few seconds to show you the voltage. Now, I removed the red prong from the current conducting part. Now, the high impedance part of this motor, I mean, this multimeter is now connected. Now, if it stops moving, now we have a reading. This is 240 volts draw, okay? So, obviously this is a type of motor whose voltage drops under load just like any other. Now, as you can see, this will slowly increase.